The world was not always covered in miasma. As a matter of fact, we used to live all over the surface of the earth, in scattered outposts and bustling cities. Whether it was by divine punishment or a consequence of human greed, we lost all those things and more. These days, folks live on barren mountaintops, fearing the day the miasma's fog rises high enough to poison what little land there is left. Certainly, there were a brave few who tried to stem the tide, but they paid dearly for it, with nothing in return. No, there is little hope for long-term survival now. Instead, towns like Little Rock endure to thrive as much as they possibly can. With the time they have left, they establish initiatives like the Homestead Arcana Program, which places witches of age at lower elevations so they may cultivate plants for back home. With the lack of viable land, this means witches settle right next to the border where the miasma lies. Though Little Rock Council cannot officially take action, they strongly advise these witches to avoid the miasma at all costs. For fear of death, or worse.
This is your stop, ain't it?
Got everything on you, bud? Thanks for the ride, Abraham.
Yep. Well, see you later. Son willing, of course.
All right, let's mosey on down. There it is, the Dust Eater. That means we've reached our spot. This place has hardly changed. Well, except for all that miasma. You didn't notice? Trust me, all that purple gas didn't used to be so high up. But what can you do? Anyway, Councilman Narrows has given me the honor of overseeing your initiation rites. Normally, he'd be running it, of course, but I've only been back for a week, you know? I wanted to see for myself how much you've improved since I last saw you. So the first rite is to establish a home. After all, you can't be a homesteader without a home. Unfortunately, you'll need to start off with a tent. Not the most sturdy of structures, but gotta start somewhere. Keep the elements out? Probably. Maybe. Don't worry. You'll get the materials to build a proper house before long. Just like your Aunt Matilda did. Now, the second rite demonstrates your botany know-how. You'll need to plant a seedling and then make it grow. We'll start with a Little Rock favorite. Corn. Right? Now I want to see you cast a watering spell. A little. Of course, channeling is much more effective. You do know how to channel, right? Stop pulling my tail. I've seen you channel before. Channeling is that thing you do where you pull mana from the earth and guide it through the plant, making it instantly grow. You know, channeling. Now stop making me look like a fool and show me you can channel. Thank you. imagine if you couldn't channel, huh? Your plants would take forever to grow. Of course, you don't want to overdo it and blight the poor thing. All things in moderation, right? The second rite is complete, and now time for the third. You'll prove yourself as a witch by building a cauldron and then brewing spell potions. Now, I can't just give you a cauldron. That's part of the witching test. But technically, a workbench doesn't have anything to do with being a witch, right? Are you sure that's the best place for it? Try moving it to a better spot. Not sure if that's a good spot for it either. No matter. If you change your mind, you can just move it again. Anyway, the cauldron. You'll need wood for the foundation, lavender for purification, and metal for the, well, cauldron. You can get some of those things in the meadow to the north, but that's blocked off. Luckily, I have all the ingredients you need. Very nice. All it needs now is something brewing in there and you'll be a real witch. Which brings me to the third rite, potion making. With what you've currently got, you'd only be able to make a ripple potion. But that's all right. Ripple is plenty useful. Oh, right, you need silver. Before you ask, I do have some on me, but these will be the last of the handouts. People are always losing things, right? And Ripple is great for finding stuff, so this'll be a bestseller for sure. Anywho, you've just completed the initiation rites, so you're now officially a part of the Homestead Arcana program. Congratulations. Your reward lies in... Oh no. You have to understand, the miasma tides are unpredictable. When I hit it a week ago, the border was a good 10 yards away. What I'm saying is, I think your prize is in the miasma. Yeah, it's not good at all. I was hoping it wasn't going to come to this. Well, not so soon, anyway. When you're ready, meet me by the border and listen to my instructions, okay? As soon as you walk through that veil, you're gonna be breathing miasma, and you're really gonna feel it in your lungs. That's why it's important that you find the reward as soon as possible. It's in a crate not too far from here, but it might be hard to see it. Drinking a ripple potion will enchant your sight and help you see better. Come on, give it a sip. The ripple potion yet? Did you drink the ripple potion yet? Notice how I'm big and bright? Anything important will light up like I do. Okay, don't stay too long in the miasma. Keep an eye out for a wooden crate. It shouldn't be too far from the entrance. Okay? Are you dizzy? How's your breath? Your blood pressure? Are you sure? Maybe it's a miasma talking. Either way, we need to get you some food. The box had blasting powder, right? You should be able to use it to destroy the pink stone that's blocking the path up north. Over there, we should be able to get you a quick bite to eat. How's it going? What do you want to talk about? What do you want to talk about? If you're ever curious about something, I'm always here.
Oh, a crab apple. Give it a bite.
Feeling better? You should keep looking around here, by the way. Lots of wood, metal, various herbs and spices. Now, I understand that you might want to explore the miasma some more, but there are other things you can be doing. For example, Abraham should be coming back any time now, and when he does, he'll have useful things to buy. And, oh, I think you have mail. You should always be checking your mail. Never know what's going to be in there. How's it going? What do you want to talk about? What do you want to talk about? If you're ever curious about something, I'm always here. How's it going? Yeah? What is that?
Mm-hmm.